Are we on YouTube right now?
We're live.
Get over here. This is Brad, and he's from Bear City Impact here in New Bern, North Carolina. And he's the one who helped me set up four online art classes. And I so much appreciate you. Bravo, bravo, bravo. So if y'all are interested in doing your own online, this is the guy to talk to.
Anyways, and if you're interested in getting an art class online, this is the lady to talk to.
That's right. It's me.
look at all this fun stuff she's got here.
Yeah, we've got...
We got this little... Can I hold him? Is he expensive if I break him?
Well,
he's like a little...
Get another one.
He's a little guy.
Get him at IKEA.
He looks like he's like ready to like get a shoe shine or something.
Anyway, you can learn how to paint and how to draw. And actually, the whole goal of it is really just to have fun. So
why don't we do a little quick lesson? Why don't you try and draw that man, or what would you do with him?
Let's go here.
So let's do your let's see. Let's go to your main with Lisa. Look at that. Okay, now.
Oh, look at that. I love it.
All right.
Okay, so right now he is actually like really foreshortened. That means he's coming straight up out of the front. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a little contour, and I just kind of follow the outside lines of where he is. So I'm not really looking at the paper. It's called blind contour drawing. And so where I put these lines, I'm not really sure, but I'm taking my time finding the outlines. So this is one way of drawing. And each one of these circles is a joint in the body. That means there's a place where the body bends. And so a foreshortened picture, of course, is, but anyway, there you go. You have a little drawing just like that.
Okay, now Lisa,
yeah,
can you paint me like one of your French woman?
Did you say paint you?
Or,
yeah,
it's the thing from Titanic. The
oh,
Titanic.
That right,
yeah,
I remember.
My ass or, right. I say that to like basically every single art person because I think it's hilarious. But it's kind of like funny to me, basically. So, but look, I got my official. You can't see this here, but I got an official apron here.
We both have our aprons on because.
But we both have like dark shirts. So
yeah,
it's
you get
kinda, like,
paint
unnoticeable.
All over the place.
Yeah, or anyway, Sharpie.
Yeah, you can use a Sharpie. No mistakes whatsoever. Every line you add is a work of art.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I think you could have had a little bit longer of a line here, though.
Probably.
I don't know why I'm critiquing. So now what's this over here?
Oh, this right here is what you call your palette. And palettes are really neat because you can kind of hold it like in
a like is it a tasty palette? Like
yeah.
Is it palatable?
A French artist.
Oh, I see.
So you put your paints on here and then you mix them up and then you go ahead and you put them on the canvas. So you mix your paints. You spend a lot of time finding the right color. Or the right value of like darkness or lightness, and then you put that one brush stroke on the painting. I heard one teacher say that you spend probably 20 minutes figuring out the colors or the values, and then take that color and just one brush stroke on the painting, and that's a work of art.
So is this something you're going to be teaching as well?
Yes, I'm going to be teaching color theory. How colors work, the warm colors, the cool colors, how to do perspective, how to do faces, how to do gestural drawing, blind contour. A face is pretty easy. This is a quick version of it, divided in half. Then you divide this section right here down to here, and you divide that in half. And then you, from here to here, you divide that in half. And all of a sudden, you've got eyes.
I would assume that face is upside down right now.
You've got nose. And then this is the
separation
of the
down.
Lips. And then right here, you've got your neck. Over from the tip bottom of the nose, you've got the bottom of the ear. A little bit above the eye, you've got an eyebrow. And that's the top of the ear. Now, the ear doesn't come out like a semicircle. It comes down like a little wiggle. And then you have another one over here. Comes up a little wiggle. Now everybody has a different kind of hairline. I've got a large forehead, so I go ahead and I measure mine by going like this. Okay, so from my eye down to the separation of my lip is about the same distance to my forehead. So I can measure from here bring it up to here, and that's how I know that's where my forehead starts. And then I got my scribbles, and I got my hairs way up here, and so there you go. There you have your face.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I want to buy it.
$22.95.
I'm such an agitator. So, okay, yeah. So, hey, yeah. So, look. So, this is what we're doing here. We're just switching, right? So, look. So we're going from, command one.
Command one.
Does your just overhead and you.
Okay.
Right? Command two does your split. Okay.
Right.
Command three does just Lisa.
Okay.
And then command four does just only the artwork without the little bubble.
I think I can remember four
see
numbers.
That? Yeah. And even if not, you just cycle through. See, I'm just cycling through them.
Oh, that's awesome.
Right?
Yeah.
Pretty simple.
Right. I think I can do more than one thing at a time.
Yeah. You can have more of these. You can have up to 9 that are hotkeys.
Uh-huh.
You can actually have like 50 scenes. Like, you wouldn't be using 50 scenes, but you could have a whole bunch of them. But 9 of them can be assigned to the command.
Oh,
thing.
I see, because we only have 9 commands.
That is correct.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That is correct, yeah. Now, there are other things that you can do later to make it easier. But look, we even got like little... Hey, did everybody like this? A little applause.
What? Where did you get the applause?
It's in the sound effects panel.
Oh, that's hilarious. Wait a minute. I see someone riding a bicycle. That's hilarious. Okay, we're still recording.
This one's my favorite here.
Uh-huh. I told you. Anyway, he's got a live broadcast that goes weekly, right? Are we talking weekly, your broadcast?
Yeah, I do it weekly. Yeah,
yeah.
I just did one yesterday with
Hope.
Yeah,
yeah.
Hope from Hopeful Balance.
Yeah, Hope is, if you come back here, then they can see you. But Hope has the local yoga.
Mm-hmm.
She is a very good, flexible person. And Brad is so kind.
Not to be confused with local yogurt.
Brad is so kind, he brings people on and then has a little interview, a little talk. He brought me on, and we talked about art the whole time. It was really fun. I really enjoyed that.
You know, I should show them my work of art. I should show them my one. And look, my work is in art. Oh, you know what? I meant to take a picture of this for my wife. She didn't believe that my work was in an art gallery. Here we go, ready?
Uh-huh.
Here we go. So this is my work of art.
That's right. Now he does what you call calligraphy, and it takes a long time to practice on the lines and the structure and you want. Isn't it lovely? Isn't it wonderful? You did a really nice job. You really only get one chance. Once you put that ink down on the paper,
yes,
it's done. You get one chance.
There's no erasers.
Yeah.
Although with the iPad, I do, they have calligraphy brushes, but they're definitely not the same.
Right.
It's the feeling of the digital pen is definitely not the same as an ink pen, but
right.
But it's still kind of fun just to doodle.
Right.
You know, so that's why I like that with the pen there to doodle. But yeah.
So you're all gonna join me, right? You're all gonna join on board.
Oh wait a minute, we gotta show them where to go here.
Oh, that's right. That's my email address. If you want to get in touch with me, art@lisabisbee.com.
Hold on. I made a custom sign here.
Technology is amazing.
Ready?
Art@lisabisbee.com. Hey.
All right. Okay. All right. Well, I think we're good.
Uh-huh.
I think we're good. And then to finish, you're just going to click the little, tap the little finish button there.
Over and out, y'all. See you next time.
And then end broadcast. Sorry.
End broadcast.